Another application of COVID antibodies is in convalescent blood plasma treatments, recently hailed as life-saving for COVID-19 sufferers. However, the treatment is not without controversy.
While convalescent in the conventional sense means old, in medicine it means the later stage of an infectious disease or illness when the patient recovers. Now, all over the country, people who have recovered from COVID-19 are being asked to donate their blood to save lives. You see, the plasma in their blood may contain antibodies that can actually attack coronavirus. But the treatment hasn't gone through rigorous clinical trials, and many are very skeptical of its quote-unquote breakthrough status. Safety is also a major concern. So, does this treatment's potential benefit outweigh the inherent risk?
Bioethicist Dr. Arthur Kaplan joins us to explore this topic further, but first, Dr. Madan, how effective is this plasma treatment for COVID patients?
Right now in the current context, you know, COVID-19, the convalescent plasma is being touted as a breakthrough or a miracle treatment, and that's not the case. There still needs to be more investigation in terms of how effective convalescent plasma is, because while it does seem to be safe and effective, that may not be the case for everybody.
And before I get to Dr. Kaplan, let's just explain very clearly to people what we mean by plasma when we say convalescent plasma.
So plasma is really the liquid portion of the blood. And so when an individual is infected with COVID-19, after a certain period of time, for example, 2 to 3 weeks, they develop antibodies. And so when you want to donate your plasma, they first test to make sure you've had COVID-19 before. And then they also do a quantitative test to see the level of antibodies in your blood. And then you go ahead and you go through the procedure, which could be 2 to 3 hours. And then that plasma can then be used for individuals that are currently infected with COVID-19 to help lessen their symptoms.
Great. Now dozens of hospitals are defying the FDA's decision to allow broader emergency use of convalescent blood plasma to treat COVID-19. Dr. Kaplan, explain why you think this just might come down to ethics.
Look, we have a treatment that has been touted as super effective, but it isn't. And we have not established that. And that means that people are scrambling around to try and get access to something that really its impact is unknown. You also have a situation ethically where you're collecting the plasma, the people collecting it are going to make some money selling it, providing it. There's a little bit of a conflict of interest. I've seen some sort of social media conversation recruiting people to do this. And you know, there's a business aspect to it that really kind of complicates trying to assess whether this actually works. Look, even if it does work, it's in very short supply. Let's say it only worked on people in the hospital for 3 days after they got admitted. You don't want to waste it on a slew of other folks who wouldn't benefit. You're in a situation, too, I've never seen this before, where hospitals, even though the FDA has said, okay, you can use it, many are saying we're not going to use it until or unless we put it into a clinical trial. We don't care about all the hype. We're going to study it. I've never seen that before with a hospital saying we're taking the moral view that the right thing to do is to test it, not just give it.
And Dr. Madad, when you talk about this particular treatment, what are some of the potential risks of the treatment compared to what their benefits may be?
You can actually have lung damage, you can have breathing problems. So there's a number of different issues that an individual can have in terms of adverse, reactions. And this is why you need to go through, you know, the scientific process to actually test to see if, a certain intervention is safe. And that's really where it's all coming down to.
Well, Dr. Madad and Dr. Kaplan, thank you so much for keeping the conversation right where it should be based on the science.